Hey guys, welcome to the edge of real and cyberspace. Today we are video blogging on the road once again in HD. I am testing the Sony, what's called MHS-PM1 portable recorder. We're going to walk a little bit into town because I have some errands to run. And then we are going to review the Acer EEE box, which I installed as my home server. Enjoy! Hey guys, welcome to the edge of real and cyberspace, where there's only one place you can go. Welcome to kwtv0017 already, reviewing the Asus EEE box. Last week we had a little bit of a problem here at Casa del Knightwise, because in the morning I tried to boot up my Linux server. I have a self-built Linux server with an Atom main board with a processor on board, 2 gigs of RAM and a terabyte drive, which I've got in this nice media housing. Well, I got up in the morning because mostly it's running 24/7, and I activated, you know, I just turned on my iPad and I thought, you know what, I'm going to browse some podcasts and I'm going to look at some stuff over Air Video. Air Video is a program that allows you both on the iPad and on your iPhone to stream videos from a shared storage somewhere. And it doesn't have to be iTunes. Great little app. You need a server-side application that runs, and you need to specify what directories you want to share with media files in it. And then you've got the client side on the iPad, which you just basically start up and select what you want to watch. Server side takes care of the streaming. You can watch your content on your iPad. Very nice stuff. However, unfortunately, I got the error, your airport or Air Video server is not available. So I was a little bit troubled, so like, strange. Walked over to the server and tried to turn it on, and it didn't work. No power, nothing happened. I was a bit nervous because I had made quite a few backups in the cloud, but I did have a lot of local data, which is just too big to back up. I'm talking about our DVD collection that has been digitized and stuff like that. You can't place that in cloud storage, just too much, would just be too expensive. So I was a little bit worried. I had the opportunity to replace the power supply, but that would mean getting out and looking for a power supply, or just basically replace the entire server. And I was planning on doing that anyway. So what I ended up with was going to Liège, to the shopping mall that I featured in the pictures a few weeks ago, the MEDIA CITE in Liège, in Leuk, which is not far south from here. And I picked up this baby. This is the Asus EEE Box PC. This is actually the desktop nephew of the Asus EEE PCs. Now, if we take a look at the specs, this baby is the 501, if I'm not mistaken, U, the EB1501U model. There is also a P model, and there are also lighter models. The reasons I went for this one is because it has a DVD slot in the actual module, which makes it great for a DVD player. Now, the specs it comes with is... it has a Atom 330 1.6 GHz processor, an NVIDIA Ion video card. It comes with an 802.11n wireless, and with a 250 GB 2.5-inch drive. Unbolts 2 GB of memory, so it basically matched up with the server that we already had, but it was much smaller. I'm much cooler looking. So I ended up buying that, installing it, and the unboxing, I made some videos, and I've made some videos how I run the machine in the house, and we're going to take a look at those as we review the Asus EEEbox. Where's the number? Number! Okay. Number? Alright. EB151U. How about naming your kids like that? Hello, EB151U, how are you? Oh, hi, it's Sony XBZ. The EEEbox is a pretty heavy unit, actually, once it's unboxed. We'll take a look at the front, where we have the slot loading DVD, we have the card reader, we have the two USB ports and the two analog audio ports together with the power button. At the back, you've got the wireless N antenna, which is not very elegant, four USB ports, a VGA port, not a DVI, an HDMI port and an eSATA port, and again, an analog audio port, network card and a place to screw on the mount. Once on the mount, it's a very elegant device, very, very quiet. As you can see, once again, two analog audio ports, USB card reader, slot drive, little light that blinks when the DVD's on, power button which lights up when the device is on, and on top you have the cooling grill and the HD light which blinks when the drive is active. Okay, this is the EEEbox like we have it mounted in the house. So you can see, not a lot of cables going out here. Basically only the power cable, the sound cable, the RGB cable to go to the TV. I had tried to connect it via HDMI, but the video or the picture was actually a little bit off. It looked like the resolution that the machine was putting out didn't quite add up with the resolution our TV could do. Although it is a an HD TV, the image was a little bit askew, so it was too far up top and too high below, stuff like that. You couldn't see the menu bar, so I connected it via RGB connector, standard RGB connector, and it worked fine. Too bad that this baby doesn't have a DVI connector, but it does have a HDMI out and a eSATA out, so you can't expect everything. Here I'm only using one of the six USB ports for my keyboard and mouse wirelessly, and one to hook up an external drive to do my backups on. Actually, I'm going to hook up a secondary external drive here just to use it as a medium to store all kinds of stuff on, just to basically put all our movies on there. Front loading CD slot here, that's really nice. Card reader, again, two USB ports, very handy when you're just poking in memory sticks. Analog audio and microphone, so very nice. This is also very cute. We just, you know, come home, have our little SD card with pictures with us. Basically, just pop it in, and you're good to go. I'll fetch a DVD. Let you experience that. Hold on. Here we go. So with DVDs, it's kind of hard to know which way do I have to put them in. Do I have to put them in glossy side to there or to here? So I'll try this way. Normally this should work. And there you go. It just takes the DVDs like that. Very convenient, very quiet unit. Nope, I did it the wrong way. It's actually that way. So the glossy side has to be pointing towards me. Here on top, I hope you can see that, here's a little LED light in the casing, and that actually blinks when the hard drive is active. and just basically pulses a dull white color when the device is just on. Although it's on and at the moment it is playing a DVD, it is absolutely silent. Very, very nice piece of kit to have in your house. The Asus EEE Box PC.
Love is like candy on a shelf. You want to taste and help yourself. The sweetest things are there for you. Help yourself, take a few. That's what I want you to do. We're always told repeatedly, the very best in life is free. And if you want to prove it's true, baby, I'm telling you, this is what you should do. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms. Just say the word and they are yours. Just help yourself to the love in my heart. Your smile has opened up the door. The greatest wealth that exists in the world could never buy what I can give. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms, and then let's really start to live. All right. Yeah. My heart has love enough for two, more than enough for me and you. I'm rich with love, a millionaire. I've so much, it's unfair. Why don't you take a share? Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms. Just say the word and there you are. Just help yourself to the love in my heart. Your smile has opened up the door. The greatest wealth that exists in the world could never buy what I can give. So help yourself to my lips, to my arms, and then let's really start to live. Just help yourself to my lips, to my arms. Just say the word.
Okay, I hope you liked that little review of the Asus EEE Box PC, which is, as you can see, performing magnificently on our home TV using Ubuntu 10.10. Very pleased with the device, very pleased with the fact that it's very, very quiet. Even now, it's playing a physical DVD. You can hardly hear the machine humming. Really, really quiet, and according to the leaflet, it would appear to have a power usage of about 25 watts, so you can leave it running. It should consume the power, 1/10 of the power of a regular PC, so I'm very pleased that I can use that device to be our server who's on 24/7 if need to. The great thing about the BIOS, which I didn't mention earlier, is the fact that the BIOS comes with an auto timer. So I've configured the BIOS to come with a timer that switches the device on in 4 in the afternoon before me and Niana get home. And it's on all night, and in using a cron script on the Linux operating system, I tell the device to shut itself down at 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock. When we turn in, so it doesn't even run during the day, and everything is automated. Very, very nice. I was really pleased with the build quality. I was also really pleased with the remote control that came with it. I was not pleased with the fact that the device was running Windows 7, and I wasn't gonna keep Windows 7 on there, so I just wiped the system,